Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to TGSR Sidebar, where all shitheads deserve to have buildings dropped on their head.
He should have had to.
He almost had to.
I'm satisfied with the one. It knocked him out and put him in his friggin' place.
Trust me, Sora's not in his place by no means. So here we have episodes 35 and 36. And just to say 35 outright, because we got it at the end of the episode, the Academia in the Resistance. In episode 36, the spoiler.
Of course.
We're coming off the very shocking duel of Shun and Sora that showed us just who Sora is behind that cute little mask he likes to wear. Showing that he is in fact a monster in of himself who hunts people. Duelist and non-duelist alike. So, how are we going to deal with that? How are our main characters going to deal with this?
Same way I have. Screw it, let it explain itself.
Because remember, Yuya, Yuzu, and Noboru have befriended Sora, have considered him a friend, and now they see just who he really is.
A whack job that needs to be locked up in a loony bin?
Maybe.
That's what I see.
And now they see just what the Resistance is fighting. Hunters who consider them nothing more than prey. Nothing more than scum to be washed away.
But what is it that is causing them to think that way? Everyone has a reason. Maybe it's not that great of a reason, but these guys have some kind of reason to see them as nothing but prey.
Keep in mind, Sora said that they hunted them for fun.
But why? What?
It's a mentality lock. You are better than Exceed. You are better than any other summoning method. Fusion is better. You are better. You can crush them. You can hunt them because they aren't human. The mentality.
I guess they're pretty much the Hitlers of the Yu-Gi-Oh! World. That was a bad joke.
I was about to say, I wouldn't go that far, jeez.
That was a bad joke, I'm sorry.
So, Sora and Yuto. Gonna have a little conversation. And a duel. And as I said, Yuya's gonna be caught in the middle. And what happens in these next three episodes? These two, and the next one after this, are gonna set Yuya down a path that there's no coming back from, more than likely. And it's not a good path. It's gonna set this show on a path that there's no coming back from. And it's not a good path. You want to see how dark this show gets? Let's see how dark this show gets. So, any thoughts going into this episode? Or mainly about this episode, about these two episodes we're going to watch?
Nope.
No.
Alrighty then. Let's get rolling with episode 35. Links are down in the description below. We shall be watching the subs provided by the wonderful duo or more. I'm not sure how many people work for mono subs or work within mono subs. But provided by mono subs, so.
Anyway. To the point.
We're going to be taking a look at episode 35 here in 3, 2, 1, go. Poor Yuya. Having his heart crushed right there. And seeing Sora crushed by a building. Which is still satisfying, mind you. Unfortunately, sorry, you're not getting that rematch. But you do get to duel the other Resistance member. Isn't that fun?
Yeah, and the only reason he's even going to get the chance to duel Yuto is going to simply be because Reggie didn't want nothing to happen in the public eye.
Oh, don't worry. Shin's not snarling up this episode. Not in the main events. Oh, in case you're wondering, those Knights guys? Eh, they're not important. Not really. I love just sitting back listening to the opening. Mostly because there's, like, nothing to talk about. We should be getting the second version of this opening soon. Gotta love how these two are just gonna have a conversation. Nothing more. At least, not from Yuto's perspective. Well, it kind of looked like it did. Granted, he's a bit damaged in the head already.
Yeah, I'd say if it hit him in the head before it turned off, then it might straighten something out.
Oh. Well, that answers your question about what and how he is. I have a feeling Reggie's conversation with him is not going to be pretty. Also, I love Nobu in the scene. Also, hi Yuto, welcome back to the show. It's been a while.
Wow.
Bear in mind, Nobu has not heard a goddamn thing about all of this nonsense. It's mostly been Yuya and Yuzu who've been caught in the main plot of this nonsense. It's all very confusing, isn't it, Noboru? So many factions, so many people, so many fucking motivations for everything. I also love that we get a nice recap of all this nonsense just to keep us up to speed. Because we're just gonna pile more shit onto top of it. Well, we need a recap episode 2 episodes later.
Wait a minute, he said friends.
Mm-hmm.
He's a child.
Uh-huh.
Is it possible he and his friends saw it as a game, but the adult didn't?
Nope. I'm just gonna tell you right that now. Right now. Okay. Nope. And there's a gif that summarized people's opinions of Arc 5 for now. It's like, I don't get it! I don't know what's going on! So much shit! So much... Ugh. Now pay attention to how they treat these guards. Notice the difference?
Well then.
Yuta's not that bad of a guy, right? Was Sora just clocked them because he fucking felt like it. I love how Reggie's like, no, don't do the sensible thing. I want to see this play out. Now we're about to see the thing that's kind of annoying. You know how on the dual screen we get people's names?
Mm-hmm.
Pay attention to Yuto's. Isn't someone just trying to goad people into a fight? Sure about that, Reggie?
Are fit for what? I missed that. The subtitles weren't fast.
The fight against Akaba Leo. Don't think there's any finishing off Kurosaki. Let's be honest. Now you see what's annoying?
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, they never put that in the subs. They just keep it as it is. Damn! Mm-hmm. Just throwing a haymaker out right off the bat. This is the first time we really get to see you two use this deck, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
I also like how they pretty much went and said, like, yeah, an action field is in play when they're dueling, and they're actually causing damage to each other. Oh, so that is still the weirdest cell phone in the world. Sir, we've seen you go all out already. You're not going all out. By the way, in case you're wondering, this does not answer the question of where does the LDS pin come from. In case you thought about that. That is still an unanswered question. Hi, Sora! Welcome to the plot!
Oh yeah, this is the first time you're seeing him, isn't it?
Yeah. Remember, Yuzu's always been around Yuto whenever Yuya shows up. That's a nifty effect.
Yeah.
Aren't you satisfied with your little meal? Quite a big meal there, boyo! Well, that's enough of seeing Yuto's deck.
Stupid kid.
To be fair, he hasn't seen Dark Rebellion in action. Love how they're having the exact same thought. To be fair, it's still an action field. Isn't someone feeling merciful today? Mm-hmm. Well, this complicates things. Did you thought not sending Shun would prevent a scene from happening? To be fair, he looks fine.
Looks can be deceiving.
Well, the guard guy said he was pretty much fine. Only superficial injuries. Isn't he such a nice guy?
Ooh. Hmm.
Aren't things getting interesting? So, thoughts?
He's not gonna want to battle him.
Are you sure?
Absolutely. And here's my reasoning. He's trying to save his friend.
Mm-hmm.
His comrade. You're just trying to do the same thing. His step back showed that he realized what Yuya's trying to do. So he's going to be hesitant in trying to fight Yuya because he sees him and Yuya. Which is ironic considering they look the same.
Yeah. Kind of like they're cut from the same cloth, aren't they?
Yeah.
You know, I'm tempted sometimes to ask you, Tommy, if I could get the files for Sidebar so I can add in subtitles at certain points when I say something. Just little remarks I have in my head.
You do know you could add annotations.
True. But I would like something a little bit more professional than annotations.
Annotations are professional, too.
They can be.
By the way, we're about to hit when Arc 5 finally got back and then got into 2015. Think about that for a second. We're about to hit when Arc 5 episodes start airing this year.
Hmm.
Hell, we've hit the 1 year anniversary of Arc 5 airing already. Live.
Wow.
Yeah. It's weird to think about the show's been going on for a year already.
More than a year now.
Yeah. And we are no closer to the end. So, are we ready to keep this rolling?
Yep.
Just about. Yes.
Alrighty then. We should be rolling into episode 36 here in 3, 2, 1, go. Some of subs derped for a second, but nope, they didn't. Meanwhile, in the recap of the previous episode... What?
I didn't have a recap. Pause, because apparently my files got mixed up.
Okay, well, I guess we'll pause once we hit the opening, I guess, or after the opening.
I just got a big spoiler.
Oh.
What episode are we on?
36.
Son of a whore.
Did you click on 37?
I don't have to. Oh. 36 is the one that they put in a freaking separate file like retards.
Oh, they put it in with.
Because of the Yu-Gi-Oh! 2016 movie. Well, I just got a spoiler. I know what happens in the first 20 seconds of that one. Son of a whore.
Oh, don't worry. We'll get to that at the end of the episode. And it's not that bad of a spoiler. It's what happens at the end of the episode that's a real big spoiler. Besides, I believe what you're talking about is literally last minute, hey, this is how the episode ends thing. Do 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 do.
I don't need the recap. What time is it?
1:12. Start of the opening. Unless you want to go past the opening.
Yeah.
Go past the opening. Yes. No?
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, no. 1:12?
Yeah.
Then you gotta hold on a second. Okay.
Yeah, I'm ready.
I thought we were going past the opening, so I was letting it
go. So I was trying to confirm.
Sorry.
Okay. Pick it up from the beginning of the opening at 1:12 marker here in 3, 2, 1, go. And I do believe by the end of this episode, I get to tell you my theory of what's going on. Because now you'll know. You get the full scope of what's going on in this show. It's one of the only times you'll ever hear me hum along to an opening or in a commentary. Love how we now, how we take a few minutes, step back, start at the end of the episode, and before we get to move forward. It's like, we gotta do that whole Yuya standing up for Sora thing again. And look at Reggie being like, eh, we'll be okay, it'll be okay. Yuya's there.
Well then.
Just getting that good hand right off the bat.
Started giving no fucks.
Yep. And only pulling out odd eyes. Hey Glock, doesn't this seem familiar?
You
know how people from 5Ds are working on this show?
Yep, I see. Okay. Got it. Say no more.
Okay. No, I'm not even gonna do the whole strike bust. Just gonna swing yourself at him. Hope for the best.
I meant to mention it when we were watching the last episode, but, you know, technically Dark Rebellion, they buffed when they moved him to the card, too.
Yeah. Because it so? Doesn't just go back to normal.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Well, it's a trade-off. Well, it's a trading.
Well, the ability itself is buffed, though.
Yeah.
The means of getting the ability, though, yeah, that is nerfed.
Yeah. So it kind of balances itself back out. Kind of.
Instead of having two chances, you only have one. But you keep the power that you gain. As much as it takes.
He ain't trying to make a fool out of him. Nah. Sora's doing it himself.
Yep.
Yep.
Also, say goodbye to Time Gazer in Stargazer's effects for a while. Also, that was just reverse footage. Well, someone's planning ahead, aren't they? It's nice to see that Sora's dropped all fucking facade of being a nice guy. He doesn't even give a shit about you yet.
Genetic? Bad joke.
No. Plot bomb. Plot bomb number two. I'm just telling you guys right now, you were calling some stuff way too early. Probably shouldn't have gave the decade comparison. bringing back out Chimera again. Well, we're 12 minutes in, and that's over with.
We're only 12 minutes in?
Yep.
Holy crap, because that's what I saw. Okay. That's literally all that I saw.
Oh. Oh, that's not what I thought you'd saw. Well then, aren't you going to be in for a surprise? Also, I love you, Isline, coming up here real soon.
Yes.
I love how you is like, you're full of shit! Fuck you! Plot bomb number 3. By the way, Glock, that's kind of the answer to your question.
So it is GX, just...
Plot bomb number 4. Just collectively this scene. Just gonna say it right now. Hey, look, don't those uniforms look familiar?
Do I have to say it again?
I know.
True, I guess that one kind of late, but still.
Plot bomb number 5. By the way, you can probably guess who that is. Don't know what that giant machine thingy is, but it's important. It's in the opening. By the way, Arc 5 loves the end duels without having them continue. To be fair, that's what Sora said, but we're splitting hairs at this point. Aw, does the Heartland look good? Remember when I told you you had mixed feelings about Zexal from here on out?
Wait a minute, nobody was using Dual Gazer. How far into the future is this?
Who said it was the future?
Well, it can't be the past, or else they wouldn't be using Dual Gazer.
Who said it was the past?
Okay.
Who said time was a factor? When I said they burned Heartland to the ground, I'm not kidding. Damn, Reggie's even got pissed off. I love how Yuya's not automatically believing all of this nonsense. He's like, this is a lot of fucking shit to swallow.
Question.
What?
Where's Synchro?
How do I answer this question? It's there. It's important. But we're not going to worry about it at the moment.
So, in that sense, that would mean this is the same world that we would have saw in the first Yu-Gi-Oh.
Maybe.
Then the pendulum makes sense, because it's the center, which means everything flows into it.
Buglock, you wanted your war? There's your war! Plot bomb number 6. I'm sure I missed a plot bomb at some point in this episode. You get in your dreams. They're so adorable!
Jeremy, you're echoing.
How am I echoing? Am I echoing now?
No.
Okay, I guess it was just a one-off weird thing. Nice we get all these flashbacks in these plot episodes. Gotta pad that time out because, we gotta get to something at the end. Sorry, Reggie, can't see the stool. No, you get to sit this one out. We have to settle this between... counterparts.
Wait, is he... is that Synchro?
Yeah. What do you think? There's a D-wheel.
Holy crap, how did I mention it and it shows up at the end of the episode? How was that? Okay.
So, how we feeling?
It's Synchro. Question is it evil too? We'll figure that out later.
So, all the plot bombs have been dropped. How you feeling?
Pretty cool. It's pretty good so far. I like it.
Just to let you know, you're now caught up with the main plot of Arc 5.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. The overall, what the fuck is going on in Arc 5, you're caught up. For specific events throughout the episodes, yes, you are way behind. But for the general premise of Arc 5, you're now in the loop.
Okay.
You now know the full scope of the Arc 5 story.
So question is, Fusion hunts Exceeds as prey, and it seems like Synchro is attacking Exceeds as well. Question is Synchro fighting Fusion? Because if that's so, that's a three-way war, and that's utter chaos. Which means it's all going to hit the center point, the center universe, or not universe, the center dimension, and cause one big hellstorm.
I think you're jumping a little bit too far ahead, Glock. Remember, Yuta said nothing about Synchro.
That just said Synchro.
Trust me, Synchro's not quite involved in things at the moment. So, you now know how large Arc 5 is. And now I can tell you that Arc 5, that title, it's got a dual meaning to it.
Uh-huh.
And it's not what you think it means when I say that.
It's not?
Nope.
Okay, then explain it.
What are the two groups that we keep mentioning?
Academia and the Resistance.
Mm-hmm. Now think about Arc 5. The name. You notice something?
A and R.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got Academia and the Resistance.
And what do you think could represent Standard in Arc 5? Arc 5 that's made up of four letters and a symbol.
Yes, a symbol.
A dash.
Oh. It would have to be the V.
No, the symbol's a dash, that's Standard.
A dash is Standard. Oh, I get it. Okay.
So, I can tell you that. So, what do you think
is
going on?
We've got two more groups that are going to show up.
Yes. At least two more important things related to those letters. The next one won't be a group.
Okay.
Tommy, you've been quiet. How you feeling after all that plot bombage?
It definitely did what I figured and answered quite a bit.
Now think about it. You're caught up with the rest of us now on what on the general premise of Arc 5. Unfortunately, I can't tell you what the deal is with Yuya and his dimensional counterparts, or Yuzu and her dimensional counterparts.
Wait a minute, her dimensional counterparts?
Think about this for a second.
Oh, are you talking about Ruri?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry, I was kind of thrown off, and I'm like, wait a minute, her? Oh, right, we actually haven't met her. Yeah, okay.
And, don't worry, Glock, up until this point, we haven't.
Why do you say up until this point?
I meant we're currently at in the episodes of Arc 5 for me.
Oh, you still haven't?
No.
Oh, well.
It's funny how that happens. Anyway.
Yeah. What'd I get? Ooh!
So,
fighter armor.
We have four dimensions, three of which have multitude of references to previous seasons, right? And you're thinking standard is like the counterpart to Yu-Gi-Oh! The original Yu-Gi-Oh! Show, right?
Mm-hmm.
Think about this for a second. Where's a specific reference to the original Yu-Gi-Oh! In Standard?
Can you repeat that?
Where is a reference to the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Series in Standard? That is wholly within Standard.
The fact that it's a big show, and that there's a tournament.
That's the same for every show.
Same for every show, but it still factors around the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Does it not?
No. Not what I'm meaning. Elements from that show. Think about it. Synchro. What element specifically from 5Ds is represented in the synchro dimension.
Fair enough.
What element is wholly from Zexal that is represented in the Exceeds dimension? What from GX is wholly represented in the Fusion dimension? You don't have that in Standard. And think about this for a second. Yuto's dragon is Exceeds dragon, right? But Yuya's dragon is Pendulum dragon. Doesn't match his dimension and the dimension name, does it? But Yuto's does.
Wait a minute, whose dragon is Exceeds dragon?
Yuto's. Dark Rebellion. Exceeds dragon.
Okay,
lines up with his dimension.
Yeah.
But Yuya's doesn't. His dragon's called Pendulum. He's from Standard. Bit odd, don't you think?
Huh. Yeah.
The pendulum circles around the center. He's the one that brings it all together.
But you're missing that. You missed that. I can clearly see that one.
What, that all the stuff flows in the standard?
Uh-huh.
Why then is there different counterparts in each of the dimensions? Why is standard so different then?
Hmm.
If standard is supposed to be the center, why is it so different? What makes it the center? What makes it special? That's the question I'm asking. Yes, Yuto says everything flows into center and isn't standard, and standard's the center of this dimension nonsense. Why? Why do you say that? Why do you think that? Also, why is that not reflected in the imagery we see of the dimensions? When standard is just another dimension, just like the rest of them. Because that's the only time they ever mention that. The only time they ever mention that. You get what I'm saying now?
Yeah.
Yes, Yuto has his line. Unfortunately, things contradict that line. Because there's nothing special about Sander. Only what isn't matching up to that dimension. A summoning method that does not exist anywhere except there. But it doesn't match the name of the dimension. A dimension that clearly Mr. Big Bad Villain doesn't want it as an enemy. A dimension that one could assume he's from, considering Reggie is his father and Reggie lives in Standard, so why? Why is Standard so different when it's not?
Wait, Reggie is whose father? Sorry, what?
Leo is Reggie's father.
Oh. Okay.
You know, the big bad of the fucking show?
Yeah, you said Reggie was his father, and I'm just like, wait a minute, huh?
I must have screwed it up for anyone. Yeah, why is standard so different? Why isn't it an exception to everything else? That doesn't make it the center, that makes it the odd one out. See what I'm getting at? Yuto's line doesn't make sense. Unless he's wrong. Unless standard is different because it doesn't have a counterpart. It is supposed to be its own original dimension. Because what if we haven't met the dimension for the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Series just yet? Alright. So should I explain what I think is going on?
What was that, Glock?
Dude.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, apparently he's like 10 feet away from his mic.
I am pretty far from the mic.
He said
move
do.
Closer so we don't hear.
Alright. Based upon the movie we're going to see at the end of TGSR, we know for a fact that Yu-Gi-Oh!, GX, and 5Ds all take place in one timeline of events. But Zexal clearly, very obviously, does not reference 5Ds. Why? Simple answer is, it's due to the end events of 5Ds because of time travel shenanigans. That'd be the simple answer. But because of that, Zexal is a part of a timeline. What if there is some point past both 5Ds and Zexal? What if that point some point in there, something happened to the timeline. Something was brought about that caused this entire timeline we know to be shattered and created the dimensions we know. And what if in those dimensions, the history you know about those shows isn't there? Because one key element is removed. One key person is gone. And without them, things aren't what they are supposed to be. Like you said, Glock, something's not right. So, you've seen a good bit of Zexal, right? Right, yes, no.
I don't even think he's paying attention.
Yeah. You've seen a good bit of IFDs, right?
Yeah.
Ask yourself this question. If you remove Yuma and Yusei from the events of the shows, what happens?
Nothing. Everybody goes back to the way they were and terrible events occur. Jack what if... is the leader of blah 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 and thinks he's a complete and utter perfect.
You know, looking at Zexal's end of it, technically if you remove Yuma, that would also remove the numbers.
Thus, nothing happens. Isn't that what Yuto said? Heartland was peaceful. A nice city. Nothing happened.
And the rank up was able to work on a card that didn't have a number.
Because numbers didn't exist.
But rank up turned out to be just a natural evolution of the Xyz monsters, which is something Synchro, or in this case 5Ds, introduces with the form of Axel Synchro. What if rank up is simply the Xyz version of an Axel Synchro? But then let's take a look at Fusion. What do you do without Jaden? What do you do without a kid who brought so much happiness to a academy so steeped in secrets? What if you take him out?
All hell breaks loose.
Also, what if you put in someone who doesn't have the best of intentions? Like a certain Akaba Reo? Now you see what I'm getting at. What we're seeing is what's left of the shattering of what we know. The stories aren't right because they're not supposed to be. Think about this. They are so specific about their references, right?
Uh-huh.
Heartland, they have it down to a T.
Except for them.
The D wheels, down to a T. So specific in their references. So specific. And trust me, there are even more minute references in the show to come. But why do they get the elements wrong? Why is Heartland have no D-gazers? Why does Heartland have no numbers? Why does GX look like a fucking evil academy? It's because they aren't supposed to be right. It's because they're not our stories. Not the stories we know. Not the shows we watched. Because something happened. And in the place of Yugi, Jaden, Yuki, Yusei, and Yuma, we get Yuya, Yuto, and his other two counterparts. All following the same naming scheme. All in dimensions that represent series. Except for Arc 5. Well, except for Standard.
I've got a idea.
What?
that might could explain that, but I have a funny feeling that I might be on the right track, so you might wind up being like,
To be honest, the whole mystery of the Yuyas and the Yuzus, the dragons, and Yuzu's bracelet, there's no answers. 64 episodes into the show, we still don't know what's the deal with that.
Okay, then I'm going to say this, and this is a complete hunch here. What if Standard is actually the outcome of all the shows occurring like they were supposed to? However, Akabaleo went back and tried to go back in time to do something that he shouldn't have, and that's what caused all of this to happen.
Like becoming the leader of Academy and turning it into Academia.
We do find out why he's doing what he's doing, and that might jive, because there's a certain thing he wants to do, and guess who it's connected to? Not, and if you're wondering, it's not the Yuyas. Because think about it, Yuyas, completely untouched. But what do we know? Rui's kidnapped. And she has a counterpart in the form of Yuzu. And she has a magic bracelet that seems to keep the Yuyas apart. Ever wonder why they're meant to be apart? Like I said, things in these two episodes send Yuya down a path there's no coming back from. And it's not a good one. I have a feeling that Arc 5 is not going to have the nicest ending. That Yuya is not going to get the dream he wants. Because if there's one thing I know about this show, that dueling is a weapon. And no matter how much Yuya tries, it won't stop being one. So, with that dark and depressing thought in mind, and me explaining what I think is going on in this show, I guess we can end it off there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Next time on Sidebar, Yuto is going to have a rematch with our D-Wheeler friend. And this outcome? Let's just say Yuya is not going to be better off by the outcome of this duel. And it will set a precedent that while some people think is a good thing, I don't think is. Till next time, folks.